This is Ganesh Reddy and I welcome you to the Knowledge Treasure Hub. Today we are going to see one of the interesting and important concepts in the electronics, and of course many engineering boys are fear of this one, but I don't know why. But really this is very simple if you understand. So it is none other than network analysis. Somebody call it as a network theory or circuit theory, right? So we will see one by one concepts, everything. So initially, what is network? So network is nothing but a connection of various electrical elements. Then what is circuit? A circuit is a network which is having at least one closed path. So every circuit is a network, but the reverse is not true. So that is the slight difference between the network and circuit. In generally, we will use both are in a similar fashion, right? Next we'll see is some basic quantities in the network analysis, followed by several important concepts. So these entire network analysis or circuit theory is applicable only to the lumped circuit, not to the distributive circuit. Why? Because the Kirchhoff laws are applicable only for the lumped circuit. What is the lumped circuit? What is the distributive circuit? We'll see. So lumped circuit is a simple circuit which can be physically separable, right? Let me give an example for lumped circuit. So lumped circuit is a simple circuit which can be physically separable. So all the experiments we are doing in our laboratory are examples for lumped circuits. So let me give a simple example. So which is consisting of resistor, inductor, capacitor. So it is a lumped circuit, a simple circuit which can be easily physically separable, right? So this is a lumped circuit. On the other hand, what is a distributive circuit? So distributive circuit is a circuit which can't be physically separable. So it is a very big circuit. Ideally, it consists of infinite number of elements. An example of a distributive circuit is nothing but a transmission line. We call transmission line as a distributive circuit which is having an infinite number of elements. So this is a distributive circuit. So our entire network analysis or circuit theory is applicable only for the lumped circuit, not for the distributive circuit, right? So this is a lumped and distributive circuit. So now we'll see the basic quantities in the network analysis. So basic quantities. The first basic quantity in our entire circuit theory is charge, which is represented by Q. So charge is a basic quantity in the circuit theory which is measured in coulombs. So which is measured in coulombs. So charge creates two operations in the network analysis. One is the motion of charge and another one is the difference in the charge. So the motion of charge is nothing but a current. The potential difference of the charge is nothing but voltage. So charge plays an important role in the entire network analysis. And this charge is a bilateral, which means it is having two potentials. So positive as well as negative. We call positive charge as proton and the negative charge as electron, and the value for Q will be 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. So this is a basic quantity in entire network analysis. It plays a major role. So there is one law of conservation of charge, which states that the charge neither be created nor destroyed but changes from one form to the other. So we know all about short distorting from our 8th and 9th class in physical science followed by intermediate. The same concepts here also, because this is a basic quantity. So charge creates two operations. One is flow of charge, another one is a potential difference called voltage. So we'll see the current and voltage as well, which are the operations of the charge. So the next one is voltage. So voltage is nothing but a potential difference between the two ends, or we can call voltage as the defined voltage as the work done to bring a unit positive charge. So voltage represents V, which is equal to d omega dW by dt. So dq. So work done to bring a unit positive charge from one point to another point. So dW by dq. So which means, which is represented by joules per coulombs, nothing but volts. So voltage is units or volts, which is equal to joules per coulombs, right? So for suppose, let me give an example. If one positive, one coulomb of charge required 5 joules of energy to bring a positive charge from one point to another point, then the required voltage will be, so 5 joules, one coulomb of charge, then the required voltage will be, so 5 joules by 1 coulomb, that is equal to 5 volts. So that is a simple example, right? Next one is current. So current is the motion of charge in a particular direction. So typically every electron or every proton in any conductor, in any material will have energy, and it is going to be moved in a random manner. So if we apply any force to all those electrons or protons, then all the charge carriers will move in a particular direction, which is nothing but current. So current I is equal to dq by dt. So the rate of change of charge is nothing but current. The rate of change of charge with respect to the time is nothing but current. So coulombs per seconds is equal to amperes. So the units of current are amperes. So next one is the power. So power P is equal to current into voltage. Power P is equal to current into voltage. So we already know, so voltage V is equal to dW by dq, current I is equal to dq by dt. So dq, dq cancel, that is equal to dW by dt. So the power is also defined as the time rate of energy, right? So this is about the current, charge, voltage, power. So which are called as basic quantities in our entire network theory. So this is about the basic quantities. So next we will see some network elements. So network elements are mainly classified into four categories. So we'll see one by one. So the first one is linear and non-linear elements. So network elements. So network elements, the first one is linear and non-linear elements. So what are called linear elements? What are called non-linear elements? So any element whose IV characteristics are a single straight line passing through origin are called linear elements. If their IV characteristics are not in a straight line, and if it is not passing through origin, so we are calling it as non-linear elements, right? So we'll see some IV characteristics, an example, then it is going to be linear. So current I, voltage V. So it is a perfect linear element. It is also a linear element because it is a straight line and it is passing through origin. So it is also linear element. Even though it is a straight line and passing through origin, but it is not a single straight line, so it is not a linear element. So it is not a straight line and it is not a single line, so it is obviously non-linear element. So this is about linear and non-linear elements. So a linear element whose IV characteristics are single straight line and passing through origin is called linear elements. So if it is not followed that rule, we call it as non-linear elements. So this is about linear and non-linear elements, right? So the next one in the list of network elements classification is active and passive elements. Active and passive elements. So an active element is an element which supplies energy, which gives energy to the network or circuit. So, if the element absorbs energy from the circuit or network, we call that one as passive element. So, which provides energy? Active element. Which takes energy? Passive element. So, examples of active elements are current source, voltage source. Examples of active elements are current source, voltage source. So this is voltage source, current source, amperes or ion. So this is active elements examples. BJT transistor is also called as an active element due to its internal amplification properties. So this is about active elements. And the passive elements, so elements which absorbs energy from the circuit are nothing but passive elements, right? So examples of passive elements are, so transistors, resistors, capacitors, which all are going to take energy from the circuit, right? So those are our passive elements. So this is about active and passive elements. So the next one is bilateral and unilateral. Bilateral and unilateral. So bilateral elements are the elements which is having the same property in either direction. So let us take an example, then it will be clear. So an example of bilateral is a resistor. So this is a symbol of resistor. So if we pause current in this direction, it will offer some attenuation, some resistance, right? From this node to this node, if we pass a current, so the resistor is going to stop some amount of charge, so it will attenuate some amount of current. So that is the property of resistor, right? So if we pass the same current in this direction also, the resistor is going to attenuate the same amount of charge carrier, same amount of current is going to be dropped across this resistor. So if you pass the current from this direction or this direction, so the loss of energy, the loss of charge carriers is going to be the same. So the resistor is a bilateral element because if we operate in either direction, so the property of the resistor won't be changed. So that is the properties of bilateral elements which going to offer the same rules, the same properties in either direction. So that is bilateral elements. The next one is unilateral elements. So the unilateral elements are just opposite of the bilateral. So it will offer some kind of properties in one direction, and the properties of the element is going to be changed in other direction. So let me give an example for a unilateral. So diode, a simple p-n junction diode is an unilateral element. So if you pass the current from this direction to this direction, ideally it will act as a short circuit. If we pass the current from this direction to this direction, ideally, so this acts as a short circuit, so the entire current is going to be transmitted. So if we pass the same current in this direction, so ideally it is going to be act as a open circuit. So no current is going to be transmitted from this end to this end. So the properties of unilateral elements are different in both the directions. So this is bilateral and unilateral elements, right? So the last one in this classification of network elements is time variant and invariant elements. Time variant and time invariant elements. So time variant elements, time invariant elements. The time variant elements are the elements which is going to change its properties across the time. So if time changes, the properties of the elements are going to be changed. So if you take the IV characteristics of an element, so at time t1, the voltage or current is going to be different. So this is the theta 1, this is the theta 2. So this is an example for time variant. So time changes, the properties of the elements are also going to be changed. So on the other hand, time invariant elements whose properties remains the constant irrespective of the time are time invariant elements. So these are the classification of network elements, starting from linear, non-linear, active, passive, bilateral, unilateral, time variant, invariant elements. Right? This is about network elements. So we'll see some more interesting, important concepts in subsequent lectures. So this is up to today. Thank you.